Hi love, it's Coach Kara here. So today I want to talk about a problematic concern we have today in America, being in the state of loneliness. Loneliness is having a grave effect over the American people. It is now considered to be an epidemic. You know, so sources show that one in every two people are dealing with levels of loneliness. What can we do about that? Well, the answer to that, my love, is very little. And the reason why that is as time is going on, we as people, and see, I can only speak for Americans here. I'm not sure what it's like over in Switzerland, you know, what their relationship statuses are and what that looks like. But as Americans, we have changed drastically as just being civilized humans. So going from that to who we have become now is a great difference. On top of all of the other concerns when it comes to certain types of people, you know, like those with mental illness or some sort of mental instability, emotional issues, abusers, just manipulators, there's all types. Like the list, I can literally go on for the next 5 minutes of all the type of people who are amongst us. And this is why it is quite challenging just to find a suitable, just normal type of person to be with long term. And it's causing all types of trauma, stress, anxieties when it comes to even thinking about putting yourself out there in a dating scene. As a result, many people have succumbed to just feeling lonely. Now, granted, if you have never been in a relationship or never had the experience or opportunity to hold hands and kiss and actually have a long-term connection, well, you really cannot say you're missing anything because you've never had it. You can't miss anything you never had. But for those who have been in a connection and it has failed, or numerous connections and it has failed, and now you're looking for your forever person, well, unfortunately, my love, not to be a pessimistic, but to be a realist, that may never happen. You know, for the most part, most of us were not put on this earth to be a wife or a husband, spouse, anyways, mother, whatever, mother, father, everyone wasn't meant to have that, okay? Those who do are blessed, and those who don't, who live a single life, are also blessed. That's just the reality of it. But now that we have this crisis when it comes to dating and trying to explore relationships, it has become ever so challenging. Like to be able to find someone who is on the same level with you mentally, have that mental, you know, connection and stimulating conversation is challenging. It only gets harder as the generations goes on. But here's what. When it comes to having feelings of loneliness, we only feel what it is that we put in our minds, our thoughts. So that's a choice, okay? Because you can actually choose what you think. You can choose to put yourself in a position to feel lonely. And why is that? Because it's easy to do. You're not doing anything that promotes you to live your life single. I mean, you were born on this planet alone, right? Even if you are a twin or quintuplet, whatever, you're still an individual. No other human was designed to be the source of happiness for you. They're just mere, like, they're a mere accessory to your life, to your world. And I think that's what people are getting caught up on. I can't be happy unless I'm lying next to someone. I can't be happy if I'm sitting in the movie theater alone. Seriously. So basically, that means that you are living your life for someone else. if that person came into your life that you've been crying about and stressing over, come into your life, and then they're gone a month later, now what? See? You have to adapt to being alone. There are quite a few ways you can do that. Adjust and adapt to being single. Living a life of fulfillment. Life is to be lived, okay? So if you're looking for another person to be the source of your happiness, my love, you've already failed. Because your relationship will never prosper if you are dependent upon someone else keeping you happy. That's a lot of work. They have their own life to live. They had that to do before you came along. And I think that's what we're getting caught up on. Oh, I'll never find anyone. Oh, I would be this if I had someone in my life, if I could just go, you know, on vacation. Look, you can still go on vacation alone. You don't need friends or anyone to go with you. And I think we've formulated this mindset of always having to be with someone. And that's the problem. Whereas everyone now is in fear of being with people, like on a serious level. Most people don't even know how to be in a relationship with themselves. Okay? And that's also a major issue. Like I said, the list is ever long of why you may never find a suitable partner. You know, as I was pondering this particular topic, it made me remember when I was working in the mall, like after I graduated high school, at the cookie shop, and this older man would always come in a few times a week. And I started to feel bad, you know, highly observant. I would always observe, you know, people, especially regulars. And I felt bad that he was always by himself. I just assumed his wife has passed away, or maybe he was never married. You know, I would say he was maybe like mid-70s, maybe even late-70s. But he would, you know, walk the mall or do whatever. And someone day he came to purchase a cookie. And I'll say, so do you come in here just to exercise? He was like, no. He said, this is just part of one of my daily activities that I do. I come in here on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I walk the mall. I go in a couple stores and flirt with a couple of sales ladies. Then I go and have my lunch. I come by here, stop and have a cookie. And then I go to my community club. I play chess for a few hours, hang out with the people, the guys. And then I go home and I have dinner. And it's like he has a whole freaking routine. And here I am feeling sorry for him. And he's ever vibrant and lively and living his life. And he was just telling me how what he does on other days. And, you know, he goes to the pool. Like he has a freaking schedule. And that's how it should be. You should still live your life regardless. We have to come out of this state of always having to be in unison with someone. That's asinine. That is reckless behavior. And the reason why that is because when you meet someone and they are just not the right person for you, you tend to settle. You see all types of red flags that you ignore and you just toss them to the side. Well, maybe if I help this person work on this, you know, they'll be better. Or if I stay in their life, they'll change. You know, or perhaps you've been trying to have a family, you know, for your lineage, especially men. I know you look for, you know, a son or someone to carry on your name. But everyone you meet, they already have children or maybe, you know, of a certain age, whatever the case may be, you find yourself in all these different connections trying to make something happen with the wrong types of people. You find yourself just ignoring all types of red flags and getting into these situations. And then in the end, when it doesn't work out, and now you feel like a bigger fool than you did before, sitting home alone, watching a movie, you feel more of a fool now than you did then. Now what? Now you're on social media sharing a 50-part series of how you were done wrong because you made poor decisions and bad choices in people. Due to being having fear of being lonely and then panicking and then choosing the first person that comes along and try to create them into the person of your dreams. now you have this whole humiliation in front of people you don't even know, strangers, all because you were feeling lonely. And that's what we should not happen. Loneliness can be quite dangerous in quite a few ways, which is why you have to think positively. Like, first of all, even if I met someone and they say they've been single for X amount of time, you know, for quite some time, and, well, I just want to spend my days, and they just come off as pessimistic, I wouldn't want to be with that person anyway. Like, you should have the mindset, okay, I'm going to get up today, I'm going to make the most of this day, I'm going to work, I'm going to do my activities, work out, whatever, meet up with people, like, live your freaking life. But if you're just sitting around waiting around for someone to just come and hug you and love you, that means you already have deep-rooted issues from your past, trauma that you need to work on. Like, I will never forget that older gentleman. I was so deceived in that. And that made me open my eyes and realize, well, that was like 18, maybe. I will never forget that. And that's what you do. You continuously live your life without other people. You do things to make yourself feel worthy, to keep your confidence boosted, like genuine, real confidence. Having someone come to you and give you all kinds of compliments just to boost your ego, well, that's not going to benefit your esteem, especially when they walk away or they ghost you. Now what? You see what I'm saying? So guys, it really is a crisis in America. And again, it is only going to worsen, which is why you should prepare yourself to be single, to be alone, to plan your life with a single mentality. Okay? If you've already found someone, kudos to you. But we know it's life. Things don't always last forever. So again, it's even harder when you're trying to get back out on a dating scene. You know, just prepare yourself. It's only going to get worse. And if you don't believe me, go to social media. What is out there? And the thing is that I see, especially on the gram, is like the advertisements, they're exploiting women and you know, with BBLs and all that. And it's a mess. Like, anything that's natural is no longer sexy. You know, we're not being attracted to someone's mindset or their mentality, their intelligence. It's not there anymore. So everything is material, or yeah. So it's a lot going on, people. But I just wanted to make you guys aware of that, of what's going to be happening. It's already happening. You know, just stay positive, stay vibrant, live your life, have fun, do things alone, you know, shit, it's okay. I mean, a lot of people are actually with someone and they're itching and scratching to be single. Yeah, trust me, I'm a relationship coach. I know this firsthand, just dying to be single, but they're trapped, they're stuck, and they can't get out. It's too expensive. All right, my loves. Hopefully that was insightful for you. If you need further dating coaching or relationship coaching, all of my information will be linked down below. I thank you for joining me always. Until next time.